Ladies and gentlemen, this is Gyana Das from Cisco. So we will together learn and see some of the demo we do on fog analytics, how fog computing, what Cisco is doing on fog computing, and specifically we'll talk about the edge analytics. And we have a live demo which we'll be looking at, and you see the live demo, how fog computing, fog analytics, edge analytics, you can apply to real life scenario.
So take it away, young man.
Why isn't the other screen working?
Because he's needs to use it.
So I'm not sure how many can see the picture here. If you look at two pictures, you see one candlelight haircut. How many have heard of candlelight haircut? I have heard of a candlelight dinner, but not the haircut. But there are some places people still use, there is no light, there is a scarcity of energy. The students, high school students, middle school students, elementary till college, they also study in candlelight. And one of them is standing in front of you. I have gone through the same scenario.
Hold the mic closer to you, young man.
And look at the other scenario. This is one of the Cisco building. Lot of energy, lot of light outside, but still the overhead light is on. How we are wasting the energy? Some of you might be knowing California Title 20 has announced every new construction, every new building should harvest light. So that is the goal of this product, this proof of concept. We'll show the demo, how we can harvest light, we can save energy, and save also. The simple solution, if you can see the diagram, follow the number, sense the light outside. We can put a sensor outside the window. Based on the light intensity, we can open the blind, and we can switch off the overhead lights. So all three sensors, actuators, all working together. The sun is talking to the blind is talking to the light. That's what the fog computing, that's fog solution. All, everything at the edge working together. So you might be thinking, before we do this solution, what might it take? How much money will be saving? We did a simple calculation. One day I was walking in my building, counting how many lights, how many windows, how much power we can save. And Cisco campus, counting all like more than 50 buildings, is $250,000. And if I take all Cisco campus across the globe, it will be more than $1 million per year. And think about all about us. If you implement the same thing in all the commercial buildings, this much energy saving and same time, the money saving we'll be doing. So look at deeply how the solution works. So if you follow the number, we have the light sensors and the USB power over Ethernet, PoE, which connects to the Cisco IoT gateway, which is the fog node. So the fog node getting this light sensing, light sensor, you can apply any USB sensor and sense the light intensity, pass it to your app, which is your analytics engine, taking the light intensity, taking the decision whether to switch off the light and open the blind. So all the analytics engine sitting on the fog node itself. So the fog node, which Cisco is promoting the IOX version, which can take analytics engine inside the edge. So the edge analytics can play a major role, the entire IoT arena, IoT architecture, the fog architecture, and also applying to the real life scenario. If you see some of the challenge, so many components involved, the light, blinds, and the IoT gateway. So all talk, now you see so many sensors, they have different standards, different protocols, how to bring them together. That's what Cisco brings in the architecture, how to connect to different sensors, different actuators, and connect to different analytics engine. The other part, Cisco bringing the architecture together, if you see the different sensors going in, physical security, your cameras, fire safety, the HVAC, and lighting, and all the infrastructure. So many sensors working silo. But the IoT gateway, IOX, is bringing in a like a sensor bus, which you can talk from one framework to another framework. You go from physical security to fire security. You see all the solution, point solution like fire security or physical security, you cannot go across the sensor. So that's what Cisco bringing the comprehensive architecture to bring all sensors together. So anyone can publish, subscribe to the sensor bus. So that's what we will be showing in the demo. And the main objective is all the data sensors are generating, how to bring the actionable insight, how we can take action from the data. So that's basically the core demo which we'll be showing. Some of the analytics data, this is the live data from our building. You can do time series analysis. You can do several analytics, predictive model, and then take decisions. Few of the machine learning algorithm, the time series forecasting predictive model we tried out, and which is the optimal one, the seasonal knife, to do the light sensing. Can I predict another 2 hours there will be enough light so that I can switch off my light and use the natural light by opening the blind? If we don't do this predictive model and forecasting, what will happen every time the cloudy situation comes up, your blinds will be off, light will be on. So it will be like a dancing blind. We don't want that. So the analytics, the power of analytics engine can do the predictive model, and also it can do personalization. If some people like more bright light, some likes less light, we can do the personalization in the analytics engine to accordingly open the blinds a little bit or all the way. The other part is how the edge analytics and cloud analytics coming together to do better predictive model. So you go to weather source, they have the cloud API. You can do the forecasting. You take the scenario of what is going to happen in this evening. Based on that, you change your model. And you can take decision along the edge analytics and cloud analytics together. So IoT, analytics, security, lot of challenges to scale. Think about if we have to put this kind of IoT gateway all across commercial buildings, how many sensors will be talking, how many actuators, how many blinds will be talking. Cisco has the architecture to scale, to provide the security. Also at the same time, compliance, standard, all together bringing is Cisco has the power to pull through. And we are trying to get the making a better world by digitizing the architecture, the actuator, the sensor, everything. So Internet of Everything, and taking the journey of digitizing world. We are ready to making a difference. Are you ready? So now I'll ask my colleague Raju, show the live demo, which we'll be seeing here. It's on? Yeah. So you see, this is basically the normal scenario of any office building. Any office building, the light is on, the blinds are off, you are not using the natural light. So what we are trying to demonstrate, I'm demonstrating with the iPhone cool feature, the torch light making as a sunlight has come. So I'll point to the light sensor here. So now the sunlight is getting. So what it should do, the light should go off and blinds should be open. So now you see the light is off, blind is going up. So this is what fog computing is. All is happening in the IoT gateway. That's what Cisco IOX, the IoT gateway, is providing the architecture, the solution, and the analytics engine. Thanks for watching the demo and listening to the presentation. Any question?
Is this a proof of concept, or is it in use by customers?
Sorry, I could not hear. Is the mic?
Is it a proof of concept, or is it being used by customers yet?
So it's not used by customer yet. This is a proof of concept. And more than that, we are working with several lighting companies, several blind companies as our partner, because Cisco doesn't make blinds or lights. So we are asking our partners, for example, GE, Philips, to make the light as a power over Ethernet, make it IP enabled. Cisco's core goal is make everything IP, Wi-Fi enabled. Same thing with Lutron and other blind company we're working with, which make it as a power over Ethernet and make it as IP enabled. So once we have that, the partner ecosystem already, we can go to market.
Excellent. So I particularly enjoyed the fact that the only contribution from Apple on the iOS side was the light. I got a kick out of that aspect. Now, on the fog side of the equation, I get what you're doing for the processing here, right, but that doesn't exclude data being brought up to the cloud for later analytics and things like that, right? You guys see the world as a blend.
Right, right. So you can see that linking it to weather data, if tomorrow there will be rainy day, we don't have to switch off the light. It's a cloudy situation. We can harvest the natural light. That kind of decision we can take at the edge by connecting to the cloud.
Any other questions from the audience? Okay. Do I see a potential partnership, or am I just delusional? Okay. You two should talk.
Yep.
Okay. Folks, give him a round of applause, please. Great demonstration.